I'm Jim Turner, and welcome to DLife TV Online. It's going to be a great show in a new place. We'll be here Sundays at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, with new shows about living your DLife. Every week, we'll be sharing insights, recipes from the DLife kitchen, stories about real people living and achieving with diabetes, and so much more. We're glad you're here. Now on with the show.
It's no surprise to find Carrie Brown in the gym.
I grew up playing a lot of sports.
Carrie played 4 years of college basketball at Davidson and kept on competing after her graduation.
I started actually pretty much 2 years ago doing triathlon. I did pretty well with them. I did one Olympic distance and one sprint distance, and placed first and third in my age group, which was pretty surprising. I had worked hard, but didn't know what I had.
Appreciating what she had is easy now.
Then I ran into the diabetes, so it was an interesting transition.
This could be an inspirational story about an athlete with diabetes making a comeback. Instead, it's a story about bringing diabetes patients together.
We can be learning from each other and get an idea of our challenges and what works and what doesn't, so that moving forward, we can take little pieces of that and add it to our workout regimen. Just wanted to thank you guys all for being here. I'd love for every single person in this class to walk out of the class feeling inspired to just take one little step to do a little bit more physical activity.
I say exercise is medicine.
Joy Pape is a certified diabetes educator and nurse who has worked with diabetes patients for 31 years.
Exercise is particularly important for people who have diabetes because, number one, it lowers blood sugar.
Of course, getting people to exercise isn't always easy.
What's the biggest excuse? I don't have time. My answer to that is we find time for the things we want to do.
It doesn't have to happen in a gym. Find an excuse to walk instead of driving a car or taking a bus. It's important for the body and the mind.
Also, it helps relieve stress, and it helps people who have diabetes feel like they're more in control of their diabetes.
The diagnosis might be the most stressful time of all.
It was probably the hardest day that I've ever gone through.
Carrie amped up her training in 2008, but her diet and her body were changing.
I started buying tons of carbohydrates, like lots of orange juice, yogurts, heavy pastas, all this stuff that I hadn't really eaten a lot before of, but I was craving it so much. I was probably drinking about 20 bottles of water a day. So then I started losing weight. I lost about 12 pounds by the end of it.
Her twin sister Jamie, also an athlete, contacted a doctor who suggested a blood test. Hours later, Carrie got the news.
I think my sugars were at about 560 when I was diagnosed. They hospitalized me for 2 days.
For a woman used to moving straight ahead, Carrie's life was suddenly taking sharp turns.
To hear that I'm going to be giving myself 5 shots a day in order to live, it's earth-shattering. It completely changes every bit of who you are and where you are in your life. It collapsed me. It probably took about 6 months to start to feel normal again. And that is both emotionally and physically.
During that time, Carrie found other diabetes patients sharing information.
I actually started watching DLife TV. I went on all the websites. I did whatever I could to get as much information as I could.
So she came to DLife with the idea to get people together to share what she knows best.
DLife has been amazing in just like supporting this effort and just getting this first class off the ground. And I think it'd be exciting to start to get these support groups meeting on a regular basis to work out together and be more fit. Fitness is so positive. It's empowering, and it actually has allowed me to manage my blood sugars so that they're very regulated. I started to see, hey, you know what? This actually can be a great opportunity. This can be an exciting thing for me to learn how to take care of my health more, perhaps inspire other people, and all that stuff.
Beginning a workout regimen can be tricky. especially for a diabetes patient.
So your best bet is to look at the numbers.
Check your blood sugar levels. We can do that right now.
After about 15 minutes, the class stopped to measure their sugars.
If their blood glucose is low, they may need to stop, get something to eat.
Snacks were nearby, too.
This is low blood sugar fast.
It's a tricky, sometimes frustrating, but necessary balancing act.
It's nice getting everybody together and making it a group effort.
There's nothing better than bringing people together. I found the best medicine for me was meeting another diabetic.
Which brings us back to Carrie Brown, the triathlete who happens to have diabetes.
I wanted to create a way for diabetics to feel comfortable and help them figure out ways to incorporate fitness in their day-to-day life instead of seeing all these really amazing stories about these people who are overcoming such huge things. How can diabetes and fitness work together in your day-to-day life?
That's it. Yeah.